USA. Some tremendous wrestling action ahead, and here we go. Introducing first, now in the ring in the corner to my left, weighing 248 pounds from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, Tom Stone. And in the corner to my right, weighing 235 pounds from Quebec City, Quebec, he is the AWA Heavyweight Champion of the World, Rick Martel. Martel, your referee, Marty Miller.
The wrestlers have had their instructions, and we're ready to go. Rick Martel and
Tom Stone and Rick Martel going at it here. And Stone, a solidly built fella from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, as they lock up in the center of the ring. And, of course, Rick Martel, the AWA heavyweight champ, very proud of that belt, defended it virtually all over the world. And I expect he feels like it's been three or four times around the world, Vern, because he has defended that title many, many times since he won it.
Yes, he certainly has, Doug, and he is a well-traveled young man. And very quick, nice reversal into that hammerlock. Rick is a fine wrestler, basic.
Now some hair grabbing by Stone gets Martel backed over into the corner. Stone had the hammerlock on Martel. He got out of it, reversed it, and now they go at it in the corner of the ring. Martel.
Whoa. Tremendous BLO to Grub.
Flying drop kick over the rope.
Now here's a situation. As you know, over the top rope, the Liberty throwing a wrestler is a disqualification.
Now the referee seeming to indicate that Stone threw himself over the rope or leaped over the rope to get away from the onslaught of Rick Martel, so the match goes on.
Arm drag. But getting back to that drop kick, Rick Martel hit him with that, sailed him over the top rope, but not deliberately. The rope was there. Stone went over one way or the other, but that is not a deliberate throw, not a disqualification.
As long as you don't deliberately throw the man over the rope, there's no disqualification. And now Martel working on Tom Stone at the side of the ring. And a painful, painful situation for Stone, the big man from Baton Rouge.
Tremendous pressure on that elbow.
I've had that hold put on me just for demonstration purposes, and I thought my arm was broken. Now to the ropes. Oh, and look at that. Martel
beautiful
just stood
block
in and blasted him. Hand over feet, and Martel is ready. There's the arm takedown. Oh, and Rick Martel has every move in the book, doesn't he? What a combination of moves he can pull out.
Yes, he does. Wrestling really flows for Rick Martel. It comes quick and easy to him. You can tell he's devoted a tremendous amount of time learning his craft and art here.
Again, some hair pulling by Stone to the ropes. Oh, flying with the left arm, a stiff arm, touched him in the side of the head with the right. Power slam down, the cover for a count is not quite two. Oh, just stopped him right in the chest. Now look out, Stone to the rope. He's got to come off that second rope. He can't come off the top, but look at this. Martel's ambushed him. For Tom Stone. I think he was going to try and come off that top rope. Off the rope. Went over, and now Martel.
Tremendous backdrop by Rick Martel. That big slam off the rope, a backbreaker. Doug, here goes Martel.
Here's his patented move up and over. And down for the cover. Two, three, and that's it for Tom Stone.
Series of fast, hard moves by Rick Martel. Put him into that pin position, and he took advantage of it with a 1-2-3, Doug.
So that's it, as Rick Martel, the heavyweight champ, shows all the skills and great repertoire of wrestling moves that he has. Here you see, Vern, this, he's used this many times.
Right, the slow motion comes down, bam, on, right on him.
Fans, Jay and Mark Youngblood, certainly very, very impressive indeed in their debut here on Pro Wrestling USA. But as you can see with me and Rick, it's always a pleasure to have the heavyweight champion of the world, Rick Martel. Rick, Sunday, February 24th. Highly unusual that you asked for and challenged Jimmy Garvin defending the heavyweight championship. No stranger to Garvin. We've all seen just exactly what he's capable of.
Well, I know, Ken, but I have my reason. You know, it wasn't enough what Garvin did to me in Las Vegas just a few weeks ago, hitting me with a foreign object in that title match there last week in Winnipeg. This man came in the ring for no reason. As I was preparing for a match against somebody, a Canadian, he came in there and started insulting me verbally and then hit my head in the post and did that to my head. Well, I'll tell you what, if his plan was for me not to be ready for the Meadowlands on February 24th, well, he got something wrong, because I'm ready for him. Garvin, you're going to pay for what you did. As a matter of fact, I'd like for the people to see exactly what happened in last week in Winnipeg. I'd like for the people to see that tape.
Today, Garvin was out here claiming that you said something precious.
No way, no way. I'm not the man like that. See what he's trying to do? This man's trying to destroy what it took me 11 years to accomplish. But no way. Je vais payer pour ça, Jimmy Garvin. Ça garantit. J'en ai fini avec toi. Une fois pour toutes. Ça va être fini. Le championnat du monde, c'est moi qui vais garder.
Now, Rick, this is exactly what promoters are talking about. Garvin has got under your skin. You're going to go in that ring hot tempered. You could easily make a mistake.
Well, people on the East Coast know me very well, and I'm going to teach this man a lesson. I'm going to finish what this man has started. And Jimmy Garvin, once I wrestle with you, I know why this lady Precious, throws that prayer around, because you're stink, Garvin, and you're going to pay for the medal, as I guarantee you.
All right, wrestling fans, again, it's all coming to pass as part of Star Wars 1985, February 24th at the Meadowlands. Tickets at the box office, all Ticketron locations, and do get them early. We'll be right back.